Hello and welcome to today's video. This is the finale for the Drop 10 Before Summer collaboration with the Pantastic Ladies Group. Information about them will be linked down below. There are a lot of people doing this Project Pan, so I highly encourage you to go watch the other videos. But let's jump into products. And I'm gonna start with the ones that I introduced last update because naturally, they're probably less exciting. So the first thing I have here is my L'Oreal Madly in Love lipstick in the shade 102 Madly in Love. Yes, L'Oreal, it's a matte lipstick. And here is a little swatch of it. It's a red, but really it leans very orange. I believe if you saw my last video, which was maybe the Roulette Pan collab, I can't remember. I'll link it down below. If you saw my last video, I was wearing this lipstick in that video. I really enjoyed putting this in this Project Pan, so my goal was to wear it 10 times, I believe, and I didn't quite get there. I did wear it 6 times, but I enjoyed every time that I reached for it, so I can't complain. I wish I would have worn it a couple more times. I had the opportunity to reapply, but this is a very long wearing lipstick for it being a bullet form, and so I didn't have to reapply too often. And then by the time that I did think to reapply, it was like almost the end of the night, and I just get lazy with that kind of stuff. So yes, I did want to mention that I did weigh this at last update, and the beginning weight was 20.4 grams, and we are at 20.3 grams today. So 0.1 grams used. So I'll take that. That's a little bit of progress. Next up is my Becca, it's not a concealer. What is wrong with my mouth today? Next up is my Becca Moonstone Liquid Highlight. And I said I wanted to reach for this at least 10 times, maybe closer to 15. And I actually did end up wearing it 15 times. And hopefully you can see this here. I love this. I actually don't wear this as a liquid highlight. Like I don't pump it out and then use it on my cheekbones, but I mix this in with moisturizer or I mix it in with foundation, and I love this. Plus, this thing is stinking gigantic. So I really enjoy that product. It's a little bit, I bought it before I moved to Sweden, but I had not really used it much until just recently. And I am really, really, I'm pleased with it. Anyways, when I last weighed it, it was 72.1 grams, and today it was 70.2 grams, so we're down 1.9 grams, which is really good. Next up, I have my concealer by Maybelline. This is the Master Conceal, and I've been trying to use this in my inner tear duct area to just kind of use it up. It's not my favorite concealer. I don't think it gives the best coverage, but at the same time, I'm surprised that it doesn't look drying on my skin, and I usually tend to have an issue with concealers looking dry on me, so I have to give it credit for that. I have used 1.4 grams of product for this. This is opaque packaging. I have tried to shine a light through it. I can't, so we're just gonna go with 1.4 grams, which honestly isn't bad considering how small a package this is. I can still feel that there's some left. So maybe I'll put it into a future project, but for now, I think I'm gonna put it back in my collection. And then next up is my sunscreen. And this is in the Australian Gold SPF 50. This is a really nice sunscreen. The only complaint I have about it is that occasionally it can be a little dry on my skin, where some other sunscreens can be almost too oily. So I just kind of have to give and take and know my skin enough to know if I've been leaning dry, then I avoid this. If I can tolerate it, if my skin's a little more oily, then I can go for this and it's good. I do appreciate 50 SPF. I need that over here in Sweden, especially since, again, the sun, I've been complaining about this in my past couple of videos. Sun isn't going down here. So this is nice to have around. I wore this 22 times over the past month, and it is down 10.3 grams. So we still got a little product in there, but I have a feeling I'm struggling to get product out of here now. So I have a feeling that I'll have to cut this open soon and probably focus on a new one coming up. Hopefully next month I'll get to roll in a new sunscreen into my kind of makeup baskets. So next up, I have my Ulta lipstick, and this is just in the shade 207. And I have been using this as a liquid, as a cream blush. It's right there. And hopefully you'll see. It actually shears out pretty nicely on, I just take a sponge, a damp sponge, dry it onto the sponge, and then use it on my face. And here we are. This is the progress. Now you can see that I didn't quite meet goal here, but hopefully you can see that intro, update, update, and then today I need to draw a new line, but not quite done, but meh, it's okay. I have very much enjoyed wearing that lipstick as a cream blush. I think it's a really, really pretty shade, especially in the summer. It reminds me again of NARS Orgasm. I think I say that in every video. You're probably tired of hearing that, but we're moving on. And the next one is my Stila Glitter and Glow in the shade Smoldering Satin. I'm gonna see if this will do it on camera. This thing's officially dead. I don't think I've used all of the product that is in here, but can I just show you that it has died a glorious death. It is a crumbly mess and I can't use it. I tried to wear it yesterday and oh man, the glitter like fallout was insane. Now, part of me thinks that I should give myself some more credit because I have to figure out somewhere to put this. Because I may have not have used all of the product. Like clearly you can see windows in this product, but there is this packaging, the mini packaging drives me nuts. So the big ones have like, let me see if I can pull one out, show you what I'm talking about for these big guys. Yes, so the big ones, if you notice, they are round on the inside, so they're smooth. So you can actually get your paddle around in there. It's kind of like a concealer, like has a round tube. So the inside of the big ones have round tubes and these little mini packagings have, they're just square. And so to get your paddle up into these corners and be able to get product out enough to put on your eyes, it's not possible. So that's what it looks like if you're able to get enough out. It is a crumbly mess, so I'm gonna count it as done and put this in my empties, but it is a gorgeous shade. I really enjoy that shade. Yeah, pleasure putting this in. I hate that I couldn't get every last drop of this out without drying up first, but I did my best. And I got some good use out of it, more than I would have not putting in a project, so I can't complain. Next up is my eyeliner from L'Oreal. And this is what we're looking like now. Tried to throw a photo up of where we were before, but here is the update lines here. So if it will ever focus. So intro, one, two, and then right here is where we are. Yeah. So all in all, not bad. Very happy with that. And moving on to the next product, I have my Touch and Glow Radiance Cream. And this is just a lotion. It has, well, I can't really get any out. It has like the slightest little bit, it looks like it might have the slightest little bit of emollients, but when I like blend it out into my skin, I can't really get any. There's no more coming out when I like push on the packaging. I meant to cut it open today and finish it, and I just completely forgot, and by the time my makeup was done, then I remembered. But I am gonna count it done because I don't think there's maybe like two uses left in this, so it's done. I have a backup of this. I really enjoy this. I pick this up at TJ Maxx whenever I see it, and it's a good little lotion. I really enjoy it. Next up is my little duo here from Mary Kay, and this is an exfoliating duo, and hopefully you can see that I have completely finished this. At the first intro, we were here, and then one update later, we were here, and now we are done. And same goes for this guy here. And there is, like when I hold it up to the light, I can see a little bit on the bottle still, but I cannot pump anything out and I can't really scrape it out. So, plus this portion of the duo isn't really that great. So I'm just gonna call that done. And yeah, moving on to the last product. Now this one was one that I think I'm most excited about. So maybe I'll put up a photo first of what it looked like and along a little bit. So at the beginning of this project, I rolled this in and I was focusing on the like there's a middle shade of contour on the bottom that's cool tone, and it didn't have any pan, and I had hit pan in the first update and I hit bonus pan in this here. And then I liked it so much that the next time I decided to work on this, and at the last update I had not quite hit pan yet, but those of you who saw my last update were telling me that I was pretty close, and you were right. So here we are today. I have good size pan on it, and I'm really stinking excited about it. Now, one thing I will say is I dug into this guy trying to help tone this guy down, and this thing barely, I mean, besides the mess around the pan, it barely looks used. I don't understand how there's not more of a dip in that thing, because I feel like I was like stabbing that with my, I was like really coating my brush with it because this one's really pigmented, and then going into this. And I mean, like, still, no daggum pan, or like, real, not even a really a dent in it, which is just crazy to me. But here we are. That is my 10 products for this finale. Thank you so much for joining in. If you've watched me all the way to this point, I've really enjoyed this. I want to thank the Pantastic Ladies Facebook group for, like, I don't know, y'all, they're the first panning community that I joined in on, and since then I've just, I don't know, I feel so much more connected, and I feel very appreciative to them for opening up fun projects and really curating a sense of community. And so yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.